Right there on the Danube River. I've been there. As a matter of fact, I was there for the European figure skating about 17 years ago.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. Wonderful hall they have there. Not too far of a drive from Vienna, but that's Bratislava. Let's go to Sabovcik, the young 18-year-old from Czechoslovakia.
Oh, he's trying a triple axel there. He did not land it. However, that's the first one that I think we've seen this evening. This fellow is said to have patterned himself after Robin Cousins, the 1980 Olympic champion. Big open axel. It's a beautiful sight to see now in the days of all of the triples. It's nice to see a huge single jump every now and then.
Josef has had a rough go here for this youngster. 13th in the compulsory, 10th in the short program. Skating now for experience and achievement and pride. And the future.
He certainly has some big jumps. Nice triple toe loop.
You see how small this rink really is. It's not one of your 17 to 20,000 seated places.
No, that's right. But everyone is there because they know about figure skating, and it's a wonderful audience to skate for, I'm sure.
They call it in the States a tough ticket.
It's always fun to skate in Scandinavia anyway. It feels like it's home.
Every time I take a look at the scenes of Copenhagen, I conjure up a picture of Danny Kaye as Hans Christian Andersen singing Wonderful, Wonderful Copenhagen, our theme music for our show.
This fellow was third in Skate Canada this year. So he's had some international experience. He's actually been in Worlds for a couple of years, but has never placed very high. Triple loop. I think we've gotten to a point in men's figure skating now where almost all of the men are doing the triple jumps.
We've almost reached that point in the women's.
Yes, that's true. But now we're seeing the top men really developing style as well as the jumps.